Very good morning and Om Shanti to all of the listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, and for you especially, the playlist link has been given in the description, which takes you towards the YouTube channel. Go on to the video section, next to it is the playlist. Check out topics of depression, check out topics of yogasans, different yogasans, flexibility, and doing exercises on the chair. Along with that, you can even check out relationships, you can even check out topics on diet and many more things. So all that is given in your own channel. Have a look and do share it with others too. So let's go ahead with today's blessing, the 242nd day of Akkordi blessing. What does Baba have to say? Let's check that out. Baba says, may you be seated on the heart throne. Whose heart throne? God's heart throne. Is it a simple task to be seated on his heart throne? Not at all. We try to sit on the heart throne of other souls. That means we try other souls to love us. But this is all about having God love us. So much so that he doesn't just make us sit on his lap, but the throne of his heart. Imagine that. It's a very, very, very high achievement if somebody can do that. So when someone is seated on a throne, a tilak and a crown are the signs of that. You get a tilak and you get a crown, right? A golden crown. So those who are seated on the heart throne always have a tilak of the soul. Similarly, those who are seated on the heart throne, whose heart throne? God's heart throne, always have a tilak of the soul conscious stage, visibly sparkling on their forehead. So now, in order to sit on the heart throne of God, God is always soul conscious, always pure, no impurity, no lust, no anger, no greed, no attachment. That's why he's ever pure. But we souls, when we come into the body, we become pure, we become impure. Today we feel pure, tomorrow something happens, we start getting attracted to bodily things, bodily attractions, bodily achievements, and we become impure. God says, I never go through that process. So I'm always pure. But only those souls can sit on my heart throne who are coming equal to me. That means they're getting more and more soul conscious. And that is a process. That is not a one-day process. That is not a one-month process. That is not a one-year process. It takes a lot of time to achieve that kind of stage. But then you have to be on, going on. It will be back and falls. You'll be falling back. You might be moving ahead. You might again fall down. Again move up, but then the process has to be there, the aim has to be there. It's like climbing up a hill, right? A rock climber also goes up, maybe 10 steps, again slips off. But then he has to move ahead, otherwise it's all about going down, all the way down, which nobody likes. So God says that it can be seen from afar. What? The symbol of somebody having soul consciousness in their thoughts. So that can be seen from far away. Then Baba says, the good wishes of benevolence for all souls. Now these souls who are soul conscious will have benevolent thoughts for all souls. Is visible in their eyes. You can see them and you can see their eyes. They'll be innocent. They won't have any lust, anger, greed, ego, attachment, jealousy, hatred in their eyes. Which can be seen in very common human beings who are not soul conscious, who are not following spirituality, who don't know who they are and who don't know who Godfather is. They'll have those impure thoughts, not their fault. God says, that's what I come down on earth to remove. So God says, the good wishes of benevolence for all souls is visible in their eyes and on their faces. So their every thought, word and action are equal to those of the Father. Imagine that. Equal to those of the Father. We have been studying scriptures written by human beings. So obviously those thoughts which have been written by human beings cannot be equaled to godly thoughts, godly words, godly actions. They are stories written by human beings for us to get connected to God in some way. But they are not the purest form. So the only purest form of guidance can be given directly by God. So God says, I come down and I teach you how do I think, how do I speak, how do I act. And only few souls can recognize that at the end of the days. So Baba says, God says, that they every thought, every word and every action are equal to those of the Father. How do you make them equal is what we learn in Brahma Kumaris. It's a process. It takes time to move from complete impurity to complete purity, 0% purity to 100% purity. It's a journey. It's not something which you can just drink like an amrit and you can become pure immediately. If that's how it's simple it was, then everybody in the world would go and drink amrit and become completely pure and go back easily. Well, to get into heaven is not an easy task. Just like we do hard work for becoming a barrister or a doctor or a lawyer or a surgeon or anything, here too, it is not just about drinking some water and calling it an amrit and straight away going to heaven. It's not that easy. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say, and you have a blessed day. You stay healthy, stay blessed, stay content. Om Shanti.